Hello, good morning. My name is Rachel and I'm here with Career China and we are going live from Beijing this morning. Joining me today, I have Eleanor. Eleanor is also with Career China.
Hi
Hey.
everyone. I'm Eleanor.
Hey.
I work in the customer service department in Korea, China. So I'm here to answer any and every question.
Awesome. Thanks for joining me today, Eleanor. So today, Eleanor and I wanted to talk about seven things we wish we knew before we came to China. So I've lived in China for 3 years now. And Eleanor, how long have you been in China?
Oh, I've been in China like, on and off for about 7 years.
We've got some things that we've been thinking about. We've been in China for a while. So we want to talk about this today because we think we could help you, give you some tips if you're thinking about coming to China, or maybe if you're already here and these are things that you've thought about as well. So let's jump right into it. Are you ready? Okay, perfect. So the very first one that we're going to talk about today is not many people speak English. Not many people speak English. How do you feel about that one?
I feel like this is a big one because a lot of people come over to China and they think, oh, well, maybe I'm going to show I'm coming over on business. Someone must speak English, at least when I arrive in an airport. No. You'll find that a lot of people in the airport or places like at the train station, they don't really speak much.
Yeah.
English. So you do have to be resourceful about this with Chinese channel. Elementary Chinese is really good with Kuaido. And downloading a translation app. I don't know. I just use the WeChat mini app. Rachel, which one do you use?
I use Pleco. Pleco's always been really good for me. And I also use Google Translate. They have a really good like offline version that you can download. So even if you have no internet or Wi-Fi, it's fantastic if you're like really confused and you need something right away. Those are both really good.
Just to learn like the basics, so you can at least say hello or I. Do you speak English or I don't understand? Those are the two main things that you
Those
just
are
know
great.
how to say, that you can understand if someone is to help you.
Right, absolutely. I definitely agree. So definitely be aware of that before you come, that maybe not as many people will speak English as you think. So our second one that we're talking about is Chinese mannerisms. So when you come to China, obviously, like you're in a different culture, so things are going to be kind of different. And I just didn't know how different it was going to be. Like when you're going around, a lot of people are not going to wait in line for metros and buses, and like they might run on really, really quickly, and it might kind of surprise you, that it's just a different culture.
You kind of get stuck in the subway where everyone's walking, so you just kind of get walked with them and then put onto the subway sometimes.
Right.
Rush hours all the time. But things like when you go to the train station, you're waiting to buy a ticket. A lot of people will try and jump the queue in front of you. I mean, a lot of Chinese people won't do it and they'll get annoyed by the people that do, but they just let it pass a lot of the time. But there's just
Definitely not
kind of
unusual. Yeah.
yeah.
You just kind of have to go with the flow.
Definitely. And also, things that people forget is sometimes Chinese people can be really direct with the English that they do know. So they learn description words really early. So one day they might turn around and be like, oh, Rachel, you're looking fatter today.
And you're like, what?
I'm
Like, you would just never hear something like that in the UK or like in America. People just aren't so direct and blunt like things like that. So you just kind of have to be aware. They might ask you, like, how much money do you make? What's your salary? Like, do you have a boyfriend? Those questions aren't meant to be like a rude, but it's just a different cultural thing.
You're just interested, like those are the questions that they know how to say in English, so they're going to ask them. Or sometimes a lot of you'll get a lot of Chinese people being like, oh, you're so beautiful, you're so handsome. And that's just their way of trying to be polite to you and be nice and make you feel comfortable. But go up to someone at work and be like, oh, you look so beautiful. It might be a little bit strange, but it's just their friendly nature.
They're just trying to be nice. So you just kind of have to be aware.
There is another thing. This gets to me a little bit because one of my pet hates is people who eat loudly. But in
Oh,
China,
yeah.
if you slurp noodles, it means that you're totally enjoying your food.
Right, it's like a
Whereas for
compliment. It's a
me,
nice thing.
that's
I know,
so
we're always taught
eating
quietly, but in China, you eat loudly. It's how you show you enjoy your food. It's so different.
So don't be weirded out if their mannerisms are a little bit different to what you grew up with, because right. It's just different.
That kind of ties into our next one. The third one we're talking about today is our culture shock. So, you know, it kind of goes along with the mannerisms. When you come to China, you're going to experience some level of culture shock. It's just a very, very different country than many countries that we're all coming from.
Yeah, definitely. I'd say that most people is being taken photos of. So, yeah. I mean, I've got curly hair. People either like to or be like, oh, can we have a photo? Yes. I mean, sometimes people won't ask at all when they'll just come up and kind of like take a photo in your face. They don't really mean to be rude. It's just they're fascinated, and it's just the thing to do in China is take a photo with foreigners. Sure what they do with the photos.
Right. It's just something different that they don't see so often. And so it's kind of exciting to them. So that's not meant to be a rude thing. A lot of people are really nice when they ask you.
Have you ever been given a baby to hold in photos?
Yes, that's happened. Yeah, they're like, please hold my baby, and you're like, what? Why did you give me a baby? But it happens. You never know in China.
It's funny, isn't it?
It's funny, like when I came to China too, and I had to learn how to like haggle at shops and things like that. Like I was so afraid. I was like, I don't know how to do this, and how do I talk to them? Like, but you have to like learn how to haggle and like bargain with things. Otherwise, you'll pay way too much money. And I always love haggling.
Because, you know, sometimes it turns into this whole like, oh, come on, my friend, and then they're funny about it, and it's just laugh sometimes as well. I mean, they open up prices for foreigners, so why not haggle it down if you can?
I know, and they like it when you can haggle with them. Yeah. That's awesome. So let's talk about our next one. The fourth thing we wish we knew is about food, Chinese food. So how is Chinese food different than what you expected?
Well, I don't really know. I can't really remember what I expected, but I didn't expect the regions to be so different in their flavors of food.
Same. I had no idea there were so many kinds of foods.
I think a lot of people come over thinking that you're going to find chicken chow mein or sweet and sour chicken. You can't find those. It's not the same as at home. Or fortune cookies. It's not a thing from China. You have to be open-minded and be like, okay, I'm just going to try everything and see if I like it. Yes. But generally, so when I first came to China, I lived in Chengdu in the west, which is the spicy region. And I didn't like spicy food.
Oh, yes.
I learned to like it. And now I absolutely love it. Hot pot is one of my favorite things. But the west is more known for spicy food than anywhere else. Definitely.
Same. When I first moved to China, I moved to Hunan province. It's a little bit different, kind of spicy than Chengdu and like Sichuan, but it was still so hot. And I was like, I'm going to die if I eat this all the time. But I actually like got used to it, and I actually love it now. And I miss spicy food. I think it's so good. I think the thing with, with Chinese food, I was just thinking a lot of times you can't just really ask what it is. A lot of times your friends will take you out, people will invite you to dinner, just try it. Like I guarantee you, you'll like most of the food you try.
But if you are in the south, then that's generally sweeter and Cantonese food, which is a bit more closer to home than any other Chinese food. You may find like sweet and sour there, or you know, dim sum at least. And then in the north is where like the kind of stodgy food is. It keeps you warm in the winter, like dumpling, love it. And then in the east, like Nanjing and Shanghai, those places, it's a bit more salty because I lived in Nanjing, that's known for salted duck and duck blood soup and things like that. So generally slightly saltier, but theirs is a bit more general, their food, I think.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. So
I love China.
I think it's a great, it's so good. It's definitely different than Chinese food back home, but it's awesome. So good.
Yeah.
So our fifth one we're going to talk about is having an open mind. So you need to definitely have an open mind before you come to China. This one's a big one
because a lot of the time it's very easy to move to another country and think, you know, I've read up about this. I've done my research on this. Like, I've got to remember, like, think of this. But it it doesn't always mean to say that your experience is going to be the same as everybody else's. So before I came and taught children, I thought they'd be really disciplined, like Chinese kids are really like well behaved, but at the end of the day, they're kids. So they're gonna act sometimes.
They're children. Yeah, they're the same as anywhere else in the world. Yeah. I think a lot of people come with an idea of like what they think China will be like, and or they just don't know much about China. Like before I came, I just had no idea how developed and globalized China is. Like it's such a big country and it has really giant big cities, and like you can find things here that you didn't think that you would before. And you just kind of have to stay flexible. Don't let like your preconceived ideas or stereotypes get in the way of like having a good experience and being open to trying things.
And also, I think another thing is, before you come here, you've really got to remember that, you know, all of the things, like people won't speak English, like don't have too high expectations, because then you might very well be disappointed. Right. Whereas if you come and you've got that open mind and you're willing just to be like, okay, so this didn't always work out, that's fine, because you know what, you'll laugh and you'll have much more of a fun time.
Right, exactly, exactly. So just stay open, you'll have a great time. Oh, we actually have a comment. Hey, from Dan Harris. He says, where in China are you guys right now? Where are we, Eleanor?
We're in Beijing.
Yeah, we're
right
both
now.
In Beijing. Yeah.
Yeah, we're both.
If any of you guys are in China and you're watching, where are you guys right now? Where are you, Dan Harris? Where is everybody watching from? Let us know. And we'll go ahead and talk about our next one. The sixth thing that we wish we knew before we came to China is health insurance. So
yes,
this is a big one.
Yeah, I think this was is important. A lot of people skip over it. I would say that when you get a job in China, make sure that you ask the company if you're covered with any health insurance, because some of them may give you like either a basic Chinese health insurance or maybe an international one, or maybe just, for example, a dental one, blah, blah, blah. So you need to make sure that you know what the coverage is. If you don't get any health insurance, then make sure you do get some sort of traveler's insurance, because when you come here, they have hospitals for everything. There's not like a general practitioner. There's no doctor in an office. No, they have like a hospital for liver, hospital for eyes, hospital for stomach. So you go to it, but you have to pay up front. So you won't be seen until you've paid. So you need to just make sure that you're well covered. And when you do come here, you may find that you get a lot of colds because the weather is different to where you come from, or maybe because of the pollution slightly, or just in general, you know, you're changing your routine. So health insurance is really important. You've got to make sure that you're looking after your health when you come into China, and making sure that you know your resources before coming.
Yeah, for sure.
Because, for example, it's sometimes not always the best hospital to go to. I actually prefer going to the Chinese ones. Yeah.
Interesting experience. Yeah. I think what you said basically was fantastic. It sums it up very well. You should just definitely be aware that the system just kind of works differently here, and you do need to pay up front for things. Having health insurance is very good, very important.
And you also remember, you don't get the same sort of assistance that you might find back at home. Like, it's a different sort of experience. So you just got to be aware. Like, as I said, health is important. So you need to just make sure that you've got done your research about that at least. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. I agree. So this takes us to our last one. The last thing that we wish we knew before we came to China: don't overpack. I think this is the biggest one for me. I just had no idea what to bring to China. I was like, what can I get here? What can I buy? Will I able to find the same things that I could find when I was at home in the US?
Yeah, I think I was a bit like that as well. I was like, how much stuff do I take? But what I have noticed is that in the UK, generally when you travel abroad in long haul flights, you can only really have one bag at a certain weight. But a lot of Americans are allowed
we get two bags. Yeah. Yeah,
but
people bring like so much stuff, even three bags. I know some teachers who were like, I'm going to pay to bring an extra bag. They're just so worried. Like, what can I buy in China?
But you can buy everything here.
That's the secret. You can buy everything in China.
Taobao. Taobao has everything. Like, so on November 11th, they have like a single stay, which means they have huge discounts on Taobao.
Yeah, it's coming soon.
So you can buy things from bedding to like furniture to clothes to food, imported
everything.
Food. You can buy everything. The only thing I would say is if you're, for example, I am not an average sized Chinese girl and I have larger feet than a Chinese person. So making sure that you bring at least like one good coat, one good pair of boots. But you can go on Taobao and search like certain heights if you're tall, or like, you know, maybe if you don't fit into the Chinese clothes, you can always buy larger sizes on Taobao. Definitely. And wider shoes. But I mean, do you shop in a lot of Western shops in China? They do have a lot here.
I do. They do. Like they have H&M, Old Navy, Gap. Like they do have a lot of big Western shops. So you're not going to be left high and dry wondering, where do I go shopping if I want like very Western style or Western sizes? Like they do have options here in China.
And you can, a lot, you know, I've got curly hair, so it's difficult for me to find products as well. But you can also find them in Canada. So you don't need to worry about bringing masses of them because, you know, you only have a limit. And you don't want to spend too much money bringing all your stuff over here when you can buy it.
Exactly. When you can buy it here, you'll be able to find it somewhere. There's Taobao, and that will, like, save your life.
I would say, look, download the Taobao app on your phone. It's going to all be in Chinese, but you know what you can do? You can scan the QR code if you write in Google Chrome Taobao.com and you can link it, and then Google Chrome will translate everything. I have learned
that is how you do it.
Yeah, before you come.
For sure. Definitely. For sure, definitely. That was the biggest one for me. Yeah. Don't overpack. You'll be okay, I promise. So those are the things that we are talking about. So those are the 7 things that we wish we knew before coming to China. So while it's impossible to like prepare for everything, it is good to know, like have some kind of idea before you come, like what's some great tips. So hopefully this helped you guys today. And if you are planning to come to China, let us know like what helped you, what are you thinking about, like what are some things you are wanting to know? Or maybe you're already in China right now. And do you agree with what Eleanor and I said? Do you think that these things are very helpful? Or what is something else that you wish that you knew? So I want to say thank you to Eleanor. This is Eleanor. Thank you for joining me today. And we're both live from Beijing. So we hope you guys have a great day and hope you enjoyed watching this. Let us know below if you have any other comments or questions. We are happy to answer that.
Bye.
Okay. Have a great day.